Assalamu alaikum student, I am your physics teacher from IYS school. Today we start a new chapter, that is waves and sound. So first I like to share some instruction. They take a screenshots of every slide that will be shared. So we start a chapter, that is chapter number 12, waves and sound. So today's topics are simple harmonic motion, oscillation, vibration, periodic motion, and simple harmonic motion and pendulum, simple pendulum and wave motion. So today we have discussed these topics. So the first topic is about the waves. So first we introduce you that what is wave. It is a phenomena in which a disturbance created in a medium. A wave is the vibratory disturbance. So remember student that wave is the disturbance. It is a vibratory disturbance through a material or a medium or a space. So waves transfer energy without transferring mass. Means only disturbance is moving from one point to another. Not the mass is traveling or not a particle is traveling. Waves travel in the form of repeated motion of particle about their mean position. Mean positions mean equilibrium position. So waves travel in the form of repeated motion means a motion repeat itself in the equal interval of time. So waves travel in the form of repeated motion of particle about their mean position. The disturbance is transmitted from one particle to the adjacent particle. Means only disturbance is transfer from particle to particle and not the mass is transfer. If we throw a stone in a pond, so the circular ripples form on the surface of the water and the snake-like motion of the rope are the example of motion, which is known as wave motion. As you can see in a diagram that we have show you on your sides, that there are the waves which are traveling. It means there is a disturbance which is traveling from one point to another. And now we are talking about the motion of the waves or how the waves travel. So first we have to understand that what is the oscillations. The to and fro motion or back and forth motion over the same path is known as oscillation. The to and fro motion or a back and forth motion over the same path. Okay. So, or we can say that to and fro motion of a particle about a mean position is called an oscillatory motion, in which a particle moves on either side of the equilibrium or mean position. Is an oscillatory motion. The motion of a swing or a motion of a pendulum is the oscillatory motion. Okay, it's very easy that you can find the to and fro motion around yourself. So look around yourself and try to find the example of oscillations. I repeat, the to and fro motion of a particle about a mean position is called oscillatory motion. It is a motion in which a particles move on either side of the equilibrium or a mean position. So do remember it that what is oscillation? If the particle is moving on either side of the equilibrium or mean position, is then the oscillatory motion. So it is a kind of periodic motion. So what is periodic motion? The motion which repeat itself in equal interval of time is called periodic motion. Okay, the motion which repeats itself in equal interval of time is called periodic motion. So here we are discussing two types of motion, oscillatory motion and periodic motion. So the motion of a rocking chair, bouncing ball and a ringing of a bell at equal interval of time, motion of a planet around the sun, motion of the earth around the sun are the examples of periodic motion. So I repeat, the motion which repeats itself in equal interval of time is called periodic motion. In each case, the interval of time for the repetition or cycle of the motion is called period. I repeat, in each case, the interval of time for a repetition or a cycle of the motion is called period. Oscillatory motion is a type of periodic motion, or we can say that every oscillatory motion is a periodic motion, but every periodic motion is not an oscillatory motion. Okay, so do remember that what is the difference between the oscillatory and periodic motion? That in an oscillatory motion, the to and fro motion of a particle is called the oscillatory motion. And periodic motion means if a motion repeats itself in equal interval of time. So it is called periodic motion. When a body is moving to and fro motion, it repeats itself in equal interval of time. So that's why we can say that every oscillatory motion is a periodic motion. Okay? So I hope it will be helpful for you to understand it, that what is the difference between the oscillatory motion and vibratory motion. And now we are moving toward the simple harmonic motion. Simple harmonic motion, or we can say that SHM, it is abbreviation of simple harmonic motion, is defined as a motion in which the restoring force is directly proportional to the displacement of the body from its mean position. The direction of this restoring force is always toward the mean position. So we have discussed it that simple harmonic motion is defined as the motion in which restoring force is directly proportional. Restoring force means the force which is inside an object will try to resist a change. Okay, so we can say that the magnitude of the acceleration of a vibratory body is always directly proportional to the displacement from the mean position, and direction of acceleration is always directed toward the mean position. To understand simple harmonic motion, we consider the example, or we analyze the motion of the simple pendulum. In a simple pendulum, we will discuss that how the motion will become a simple harmonic motion. So first we have to understand that what is simple pendulum. So simple pendulum is a small heavy sphere bob suspended by a light and inextensible string from a rigid support. The length of the simple pendulum is the distance between the point of suspension and the center of gravity of a heavy sphere. If we are talking about the center of gravity of a heavy sphere, means the sphere have a center of gravity at its center. So the total length of the pendulum is from the point of suspension to the center of the sphere. So now we analyze the motion of a simple pendulum, and we will see that how the motion of a simple pendulum is a simple harmonic motion. So when we pull a simple pendulum from its equilibrium position, the standing position of a pendulum, still position of a pendulum, is called equilibrium position. From its equilibrium position and then release it, it swing in a vertical plane under the influence of gravity. It begin to oscillate about its mean position. Okay, so here we have a mathematical form of simple harmonic motion, that acceleration is directly proportional to displacement, and negative sign show that acceleration is directly is always directed toward a mean position. Now we will see the diagram of a pendulum, and we can analyze that how the pendulum is working. To understand the simple harmonic motion, we analyze the motion into its characteristic and try to understand that these characteristics by the study of the motion of pendulum. As you can see in a diagram and in a definition of a simple harmonic motion, that the simple harmonic motion, in a simple harmonic motion, the body executes to and fro motion. As you can see in this diagram, that the still position of the pendulum is considered as an equilibrium position, or we can also say that it is a mean point or equilibrium point. Okay, and the maximum point, which is on the either side of these equilibrium point, are considered as the extreme point or the maximum point. So the motion of a simple pendulum is about is a to and fro motion, and it execute a simple harmonic motion. Now number the in a second characteristic, the velocity of the body is maximum at a mean position, and at an extreme position the velocity of a body is zero. Now look at the pendulum. Its center position is mean position. When the bob of the pendulum is at its maximum height, so it is considered as an extreme position. At extreme position, bob will stop for a moment and then continue to move toward mean position with increasing velocity, and it become maximum at a mean position. Here is the diagram, and you can see that the bob will come to rest by reaching the maximum point. So at the maximum point, its velocity will become zero. At this point, this maximum point, and at this point, maximum point, the bob will stop for a while, for a moment, and then it again start its motion. So at this point, the velocity is will become zero. And as the velocities are become zero at the maximum point, so here kinetic energy is also maximum zero at this point. And now the velocity at the equilibrium point is maximum. So at the equilibrium point, velocity is maximum and the kinetic energy is also maximum. As you can see that when we displace the pendulum from its mean position to its highest point, so it goes again toward the mean position. So why it comes back to its mean position? Because of the gravity. Due to the gravity, it comes back again to the equilibrium position. But it not stop here. It again start moving toward the other maximum point. And why it is moving to the other maximum point? Because it is due to inertia that it is moving toward the other point, other maximum point. And again, its velocity becomes zero and it again start to move toward the equilibrium position. Why it is moving again toward the equilibrium position? Because of due to gravity. Okay, I hope you will understand it. I again repeat the motion of a pendulum, that first the pendulum is in the equilibrium position and we displace it by taking it to the maximum point, and then we displace it. So what will happen? It will goes toward the equilibrium position. And why it moved toward the equilibrium position? Due to the gravity. And at by reaching the equilibrium position, it will not stop here, but it continue to move. But it continue to move toward the other maximum point. And why it is continue to move toward the other maximum point? It is due to inertia. And again, it is not stop here. It is not stop here and come back to the equilibrium position. So why it again come back to the equilibrium position? Due to gravity. And we also have discussed that at the maximum point, the velocities will become zero because it will stop for a while, for a moment, and then come back. And then again start its motion toward the equilibrium position. So at the maximum point, the velocities will become zero, and at the equilibrium point, the velocities is maximum. Okay, now you can also observe that description in this diagram, that at this is the extreme position and it is a mean position. So at extreme position, velocities is zero. Velocity is zero, and due to the zero velocity, kinetic energy is also zero, and the max displacement is maximum. So this is the maximum displacement from its mean position. That's why we say that displacement is maximum. Now at a mean position velocity is maximum because it is moving with a maximum velocity. Now the due to the increase in the velocity, kinetic energy is also maximum. As the velocity is maximum, so the kinetic energy is also maximum. And now the displacement is zero at a mean position. Okay, so it will help you to understand that what is the working of simple pendulum. And these are also the characteristics of a simple harmonic motion. And that's why we say that the motion of a simple pendulum is a simple harmonic motion. Now, here is a formula of the time period of simple pendulum, and that formula is T indicate the time period, T is equals to 2 pi, pi is the constant value and its numerical value is 3.14 or 22 over 7, 2 pi root L over G. L is the length of the pendulum. As we have discussed that what will be the length of the pendulum, that it is from the point of suspension to the center of the bob. And G, you know very well that G stands for the acceleration due to gravity, and again it has a constant value. So in this formula, we have two constant values, pi and acceleration due to gravity. And only one value is left, so that is, we have to find that is L, length of the pendulum. And T is the time period of the pendulum. I hope it will help you to understand the description of a simple pendulum. So I again repeat the characteristics of a simple pendulum, a simple harmonic motion. That in simple harmonic motion, the body executes to and fro motion. So as you can see in our diagrams, that pendulum is moving in a to and fro motion. So we can say that it is a simple harmonic motion. And again, the velocity of a body is maximum at the mean position. And at an extreme position, the velocity of a body is zero. As we have discussed that in this diagram, you can also show that velocity is zero at extreme position. Velocity is maximum at mean position. Now, the third point is that acceleration is always directed toward the mean position. And now, how can we analyze that acceleration is always directed toward a mean position? We have discussed that when the bob of a pendulum is at extreme position, so its velocity is zero. But when it moves toward a mean, position, its velocity is increasing. So acceleration is produced, and the direction of acceleration is same as the direction of velocity. As you can see in a diagram that here we have a maximum point and here we have an equilibrium point. So when a bob is at maximum point, its velocity is zero. But when it is moving toward the equilibrium point, so its velocity is gradually increasing. Okay, in this way, its velocity is gradually increasing. And due to the increase in the velocity, that pendulum have an acceleration. And you know, very well in that in a previous chapter we have discussed that the direction of acceleration, in this way the direction of acceleration is always the direction of the velocity. So it is directed toward the mean position. And when the bob is moving from the equilibrium position to the maximum position, so at the equilibrium position the velocity is zero, the velocity is maximum. But when it moves toward the maximum point, so its velocity is gradually decreasing. And due to the decreasing of velocity, the acceleration is the deceleration. And deceleration means the direction of the acceleration is again toward the equilibrium position. What I mean to say that pendulum is moving from the equilibrium to maximum point, but its deceleration is produced here. So deceleration means the direction of the velocity is against the direction of velocity. The direction of acceleration is against the direction of velocity. So the direction of velocity is toward the maximum point, but the direction of acceleration is toward the equilibrium point. So here we have a deceleration and here we have an acceleration. And in both acceleration and deceleration, direction of acceleration is always toward a mean position or the equilibrium position. And that's why we say that acceleration is always directed toward a mean position. Okay, I repeat that acceleration is always directed toward a mean position. So, and again we are discussing a formula of time period of a pendulum. T is equals to 2 pi under root L over G. Pi is the constant value, which is 3.14, and G is the acceleration due to gravity, and L is the length of the pendulum. And we know that length of the pendulum is from the point of suspension to the center of the bob. Okay, now we are moving toward the wave's motion. Wave is a traveling disturbance. As we have discussed in our very first topic, that wave is the phenomena in which the disturbance is created in our medium. A wave is a vibratory disturbance through our medium or our space. So wave motion means propagation of disturbance. Propagation means traveling from one place to another. So propagation of disturbance means the only disturbance is traveling. That is the deviation from a state of rest or equilibrium from place to place in a regular or organized way. And again, this regular and organized ways means oscillation and periodic motion. Most familiar are surface waves on water, but both sound and light waves as a wave-like disturbance. And the motion of all subatomic particles exhibit wave-like properties. Okay. So the disturbance is transmitted from particle to the particle, but mass is not transferred, and only the disturbance is transferred from one place to another. Now the waves are categorized into two mechanical waves. That is longitudinal waves and the transverse wave. So first we discuss about the longitudinal waves. So these are the waves in which the particles of the medium vibrate back and forth motion about their mean position along the line of propagation of wave. I repeat, these are the waves in which the particles of the medium vibrate to and fro motion along the line of propagation of waves. These are the waves which consist of the compression and rarefaction. As I told you, that long waves is the traveling disturbance. So sound waves is also an example of longitudinal waves. And when we make a sound, we are creating a disturbance in the air. Okay, when we are making a sound, we are creating a disturbance in the air, and that disturbance will transfer from toward you. And that disturbance is transferred toward you, and then you can hear your voice. So this is the pattern that how the longitudinal waves is transferred. If you can see it very carefully, that here we have the particle of the medium, that black dot indicate the particle of the medium. Okay, so these all the particles of the medium are gathered here, and then they are distanced with each other, and again they are gathered with the very close to each other, and again they are far from each other, and then again they come close to each other. So these are the pattern due to which the particles of the mediums are moving. First I said that they are very close to each other. So the portion or the particle of the medium when close to each other or pressing each other, so that group of particle is called compression. Okay, when the particle of the medium when close to each other or pressing with each other, so the group of particle is known as compression. And when the particle of the medium are far from each other, as you can see that there is a distance between them, so means they are far from each other, so that portion of a particle is considered as a rarefaction. Okay, so in a longitudinal waves, how the longitudinal waves are moving from one point to another, continuously compression and rarefaction pattern is formed. You can see here the particle is compressed, here there is a rarefaction, here the compression and here the rarefaction. So continuously compression and rarefaction is formed, and due to which the disturbance, or we can say that due to which the sound is transferred from one place to another. So what is compression? The place where the particle of the medium are close with each other or compress is called compression. And the place where the particle of the medium are far with each other, that portion is known as rarefaction. Okay, so I hope it will understand you. That is the wave motion through due to which the longitudinal waves are travel from one point to another. Now we are moving toward the next slide, and that is about the transverse waves. I again said that these are the mechanical waves. So longitudinal waves and transverse waves are the waves which carries energy with themselves. So the waves in which the particle of the medium vibrate about their mean position at right angle to the direction of propagation of waves. Okay, I again repeat the previous wave, that is longitudinal waves. As you see, in a longitudinal waves, the particle of the medium are just vibrate along the disturbance. They are moving along the disturbance. They are not moving on at a perpendicular. They are moving along the disturbance. But in a transverse wave, the particle of the medium are moving. Particle of the medium vibrate about their mean position at right angle to the direction of propagation of wave. Means when we are when the waves is transverse waves, so the particle of the medium are vibrating at a right angle to the direction of propagation of means of wave. Means here you can see the wave pattern of the transverse waves. So the waves are in a moving pattern. So the particles of the medium are just go the up and down motion. Here the particles is up and here the particles down. So continuously there is a up and down motion. As you can see, there is a continuously up and down motion along the propagation of waves. So the waves are traveling in this direction. And the particle of the medium are not traveling with the waves. They are just doing the up and down motion. Okay, the to and fro motion about the mean position. So that's why we say that the particles of the medium makes right angle to the direction of the propagation of waves. So due to this up and down movement of the particle, the waves form the crust and trough. So the maximum displacement of the particle above the mean position is called a crust. As you can see that the line, you can see the line on the picture, the straight line on the picture. So that straight line indicates the mean position. And all the particles of the waves are vibrating the up and down movement about its mean position, about that line. So due to this motion, they form a crust and a trough. So the maximum point, from the mean position, the maximum point which is above the mean position, that is the point above the mean position. Here is the maximum point above the mean position. And again, here is the maximum point above the mean position. This is the most maximum point above the mean position. So the displacement of the particle above the mean position is called a crust and trough. The maximum displacement of the particle below the mean position, as you can see, if you look at my cursor there, so the particle which is below the mean position of the particle, so that is known as trough. Okay, that is the maximum displacement of the particle below the mean position. And here again, the maximum displacement of particle below the mean position, so that maximum portion is known as the trough. And the maximum portion above the mean position is considered as a crust. So when the transverse waves are moving, so they form a crust and a trough. Here we form a crust and again they form a trough. As you can see that here is a crust and then here is a trough, and again crust and again trough and again crust. So in this way, the particle of the transverse waves are moving by making a crust, trough, crust and trough and crust, trough. And the particles of the medium are just moving up and down motion. They are moving on the up and down motion. Okay. So I hope you will understand it, that how the transverse waves are moving. Now I am sharing a home task with you. So in a question number one, define the following terms: oscillatory motion, vibratory motion, simple harmonic motion. You will find all the definitions from the book. It is also present in a summary. It is also present in a topic. So vibratory motion and oscillatory motion are present in a book. So again, question number two, prove that the simple pendulum is a simple harmonic motion. You will also find that answer from the topic or inside a book. And question number three is differentiate between longitudinal and transverse wave. So you can also find that answer from a book. said, what is the difference between the longitudinal transfer waves? Take a screenshot of this slides and do your work in your fair copies. Okay, that is all from my side.